There's a tradition in my family that every Christmas, someone sets up a modern train table. My sister's taken on that tradition, and she's asked me to build her a tunnel for her train, for her trains. This is the longest piece. Dear sister, this is how you know that I love you.
So the first step is obviously design. This is important with 3D models because everything has to be to scale. Unfortunately, with a tunnel like this, you can't always be to scale because the size would just be huge. So we're going to be using forced perspective to make the mountains and tunnel look larger than it actually is. The next part is, of course, gathering your materials. I'm using standard packing foam instead of any specialty foam simply because it's cheaper and, well, not easier to use, definitely handy. The next step is blocking out the shape. I start by organizing the foam pieces by width and length, and then arranging them perfectly to how I want the tunnel to lay. You can't see it right now, but I'm using the thin pieces so that I don't have to carve out a major chunk of the tunnel. Now remember, it's important to stay hydrated and also to wear safety gear. I'm wearing a gas mask because the foam wire cutter is basically melting the foam. And this might be overly cautious of me, but it's always important to make sure you're not inhaling any of those fumes. That being said, the foam wire cutter is easily one of my favorite tools to use on a project like this because usually cutting foam is just a pain, and so being able to just slide through the foam like butter and not have to worry about the mess is super helpful, especially when you're trying to get exact measurements like I am with this project. The next step, of course, is gluing the pieces together to form your base. Right now, the main focus is getting your structure, your foundation, and your basic shape. Don't worry about too many details, because that's going to come later. However, I am focusing on making sure that the back wall is smooth. If you remember from the picture of my design, I'm going to be painting a welcome to Brooksville sign on the back of this mountain range.
It's okay to mess up when you are working on a project. I did.
If you do mess up and end up gluing the wrong foam pieces together, it's pretty easy to separate, though it will require some elbow grease, because the hot glue really does stick the foam together like cement. But again, once it's separated, it's a pretty easy fix and you can just keep on going. Hopefully by this point you can start seeing your basic shape coming through, and you can even maybe start cutting up some pieces to help the basic sculpture take place. But remember, you can always cut away, but you can't always add, so be very careful with your cuts. Once you have your basic shape, you can go ahead and recheck your measurements. On mine, the tunnel roof is kind of low, so I am definitely going to have to sculpt that out and make sure that I'm not cutting away too much and I'm not cutting away too little, but it just comes to be just right. So remember, measure twice, cut once. Carving out the tunnel roof took me about 2 to 3 hours, and I had to use a lot of different foam cutting heads. So right now I'm using the wire. I'm about to switch to a long metal piece just to help me get into those deep crevices. But the point is that I took my time and I was patient with it, and I didn't let myself get discouraged with how long it took. These things take time, and in the end, it's gonna look pretty cool. All right, that is the first part of the model train tunnel. Next time, I'm gonna be carving out the sculpture and probably getting the base paint on, so stay tuned.